How's it going, film and TV fans? Welcome back to another review here on the Total Shit Productions YouTube channel. Today we're taking a look at another more recent movie, so recent that it actually only came out 2 days ago. And the reason why I didn't make that video 2 days ago is because when making these videos, obviously I like to use music, and at that time when the film came out on Wednesday, the soundtrack and the score were not available, apart from the title track of the score. So I was waiting to see the film on the Friday when once all the music was out, so I could go straight home and make the video straight away. So today we're talking about the fourth installment in the Bad Boys franchise, which really should have been called Bad Boys for Life, but it's actually called Bad Boys Ride or Die, because the last one was called Bad Boys for Life. And I just think, realistically, this movie is just a fucking ton of fun. Like, it's loads of fun, and that's what these Bad Boys movies are. They've always been really fun. I think 2 is the best one, then I think it's the first one, then I think it's this one, then I think it's the third one. Because I think what the third one didn't have was the two of them both going through similar situations, whereas mostly in the third one, it was about the person who was trying to kill Will Smith's character. Here, they're both in the same boat, and I think that's what pushes this movie over that kind of barrier that the last one's there. It's still, like I said, it still very much has a ton of elements taken from the last one, and I will be honest with you, when I watched the trailer for this, I was quite skeptical, because the opening sequence of the trailer and also the opening sequence of the actual film is when they are driving at high speed down Miami Beach away from assailants, which is exactly how the last movie started, and also it transitions into a wedding, which is also what happened in the last movie. So right off the bat, there was some concern that this was just the traditional trope of rehashing the last one to do a bit of tidy profit. But when you actually get into the core structure of the film, the story, the writing, and also the characters and the things that they'll go through in the film, I actually do think that it is a step up from the last film. Obviously there are those moments that are taken from the previous film, such as the opening chase, the wedding. But there are a load of new stuff as well, with a load of the characters coming back from the last movie, but also using elements from the last movie's plot to accelerate this movie's plot. For example, in the last movie, spoilers by the way, for the last movie, Bad Boys for Life, and for this movie. So in the last movie, there was a sequence of events that occurred, and this sequence of events included the death of Joe Pantolino's character, the captain, Captain Conrad Howard. Cool name, by the way. And while in the film we're shown that he is actually executed by Will Smith's son, it's revealed in this movie that his name was added, while we as an audience think that he was executed because he was part of the people who was involved in what Will Smith's son was involved in the last movie. But actuality, what we're told in this movie is that actually Captain Howard's name was added to the list by people inside of the Miami Police Department to make it look like it was just part of the ongoing taking out of people, but actually it was to cover up what the central plot of this movie is, which is to do with Captain Howard being framed for something he didn't do, and the Bad Boys have to, together with members of the team from the last movie, have to set out to clear his name. And that's essentially the plot of this movie. But you have, I think it's impressive to me that the writing actually reaches a standard where it doesn't actually feel pastiche or old or unfunny, and it actually feels like it perfectly fits the guys who are in the movie, you know. And obviously Will Smith has not had the greatest track record of recent, but I think this was a good move. And I think when you look at it from that perspective, you think, well, how is this a good move? This is just a sequel, this is just a continuation of a franchise that was initially put on hold after the events that occurred at the Oscars that fateful night. I'm not going to name or discuss anything because it's not really relevant to this video, but you, as people who are watching this video, probably should know what we're referring to, because it was a very mainstream event that Will Smith was involved in the Oscars in early 2023. So when you look at that, it kind of seems like just a way to rehash to make some money. But actually, what I think, and I don't know if it was intentional with the filmmaker's part to have it somewhat go through, like if it was a deliberate part to have Will Smith take the role he does in this movie, but Will Smith's character in this movie goes through a lot of almost mental health issues. There's panic attacks, and he's diagnosed with panic attack and things like that. And I think, and it gives Will Smith a chance to actually act quite well, I'm going to be honest with you, and also have some of the more funnier lines in the movie, because somehow, again, I don't know if it was intentional due to what the circumstances, but the way that Martin Lawrence's character acts towards the start of the movie is straight up like he's doing a bunch of like he's off his nut, and it allows Will Smith's character to have the funny, witty expressions and lines as well that he's had in the previous movies, but it allows it to have a I'm the one bringing you back down to earth, so now you must be fucked kind of mindset. But also at the same time, like I said, with the panic attack stuff, allows him to explore a certain part of the character that has never been portrayed with Mike Lowry. It's always been Mike Lowry has been this strong sort of bachelor type who always gets shit done, who's like, nah dog, that kind of shit, and it's always been Marcus that's been the more developed character. And I really admire the filmmakers, the writers, to actually have a go at trying to make Lowry a more developed character. Yeah, there's some of that in the last one where it's like, oh, he's getting old, will he won't he, with Vanessa Hudgens' character, but that's more sideline because he nearly gets killed in the last movie, and that takes center focus. I don't think you could shout at me and say, well, isn't that developing the character? I don't think it is. I think it's just an excuse to have him have Will Smith be the center character in the movie. And if I'm honest with you, I think in that movie Will Smith is the main character and Martin Lawrence is a side character, but in this movie the two of them together are the main characters, and that works so well because you have the two of them and then you have Will Smith's son. So I really admire the filmmakers for doing that kind of thing of making them both have important parts, but also making sure the relationship is even 50-50 in this movie instead of it being far more one-sided in the last movie. But all of that is kind of just irrelevant when you sit back and look at that. This is just a fun action comedy movie starring Will Smith and Martin Lawrence. It's fun as fuck. It's funny as fuck. The action's great. The dialogue is actually pretty damn fucking good. I ain't gonna lie. Like, it's not the world's greatest dialogue, but for a movie like this, it's and a slightly elevated level than what was in the previous movie, I think. And it's really great to have a story that really does feel like it's not just an excuse to make another movie again. While you can scream at me all you want and say maybe it is, maybe it isn't, especially considering the the diversion in the comments of my Furiosa video, you can scream shit like that at me all you want, I don't care. Okay, your opinion, that's cool, dude. But I think it's an interesting story beat that on paper does look like the kind of thing where it's just, let's make another sequel, let's rehash this stuff. But I think it allows the characters, and specifically Captain Howard, to have a more major role in the movie than you think he would. Because you think, oh, he died in the last one, so he's not going to be in this one. But he is. And he actually plays some quite important spiritual and soulful elements in this movie towards both both Marcus and both Mike. So I really, really appreciate that. Bad Boys is a franchise that I've always loved. I love the first two. I love the third one as well. I think the second one is the best one, personally. And then I think, while it may be controversial, I do think this actually is the second best film in the franchise. I just think it's really great. The first film is fantastic as well, and so is the third one. But I just think 2 and 4 are something really special. And I just think it proves that I think obviously Will Smith is going to be okay after all that bullshit, but it proves that he actually can still act, and he clearly does care, I think. And regardless of any of that stuff, because I didn't really want to talk about that particularly in the video despite the fact I already have, I just want to say that this is a really great summer action flick that if you're looking for a little bit of fun over the coming weeks or anything like that, and you're of age, because the film was rated 15 in the United Kingdom due to some heavy masses thrown, but if you're looking for some fun, some comedy, some action, I would go watch the movie, because I actually think it's quite fun. Go support a movie like this, because at the moment a lot of these really good movies that I have been discussing, like Challengers, like Furiosa, like Bullet Train, well maybe not Bullet Train because that came out 2 years ago, but you know, like Furiosa, like Challengers, these movies are flopping, which is real shame. And I don't care what you people say in the comments if it's about the fact that it's a female lead, it's fucking not, it's really fucking not. But that's a discussion for comments, not here. So just go and support any movie. It doesn't have to be this one, but please, if you have the time and the money, because I know money is a big thing right now for a lot of people, but if you can, please do, because it's an industry that is struggling at the moment, but it's not an important one. So you know, just go give it a shot. It's a fantastic movie. You know, even wait for it to come out on streaming and things like that, because it's a good fun movie. It's a good fun time. It ain't gonna set the world on fire. It's not meant to set the world on fire. It's not an Academy Award winning movie. And I've always maintained this opinion that you, in order to have the balance of cinema, you can have the serious, soulful, dramatic dramas, the serious, you know, those kind of movies like After Sunlight, Past Lives, like Spencer, all these kind of movies that are serious artistic interpretations and dramas and serious movies. But to balance that scale, you have to have shit like this. You have to have really funny, high octane, and rather cliched precisely shot kind of action movies like this. They have a lot of lens flare, they have a lot of specific camera tricking moments, and I know I want to talk about this more now because for me this was a fascinating insight into the film. A couple of weeks ago, or even I think it was last week before the film came out, Will Smith posted a video to his Instagram of him operating what looked like a handheld rig with a gun on the end of it and the camera in front of him as well, with a weight on the back to distribute the weight between the camera and him and the gun on the front. That shit is fucking cool. And I don't care what you say, but he made that shit look effortless, despite the fact that shit, that thing had to be fucking heavy and fucking painful, and the guy made it look effortless. So gotta give some Will Smith some credit there. The man knows what he's doing, and the fact they were able to use equipment like that and him not even fucking look like he's batting an eye or even struggling at all amazes me to the scenes level. It was a really fantastic behind the scenes insight to even see a kit like that where he actually operates the camera himself. So for that shot in the movie, he is essentially the camera operator, and I think that's really cool, and it does show that this movie is willing to use innovative new techniques and not just follow let's use a standard camera setup. There's a lot of shots in the movie that are shot with drones. You can tell the drones go around. There's even one shot in the movie where I'm not afraid to say that you can actually hear the buzz of the drone, and they didn't edit it out so well. Not a problem, these things happen, you know. It didn't take away from the fact that I thought it was funny, to be fair. But yeah, it's really nice to see behind the scenes the way these movies work, and I think specifically for that specific sequence it was quite a quality marketing stunt, I think, because for days after that I would see loads of film Instagram pages and even like normal meme Instagram pages posting a clip of him doing it, and I think that's publicity for the movie in a way that I don't think putting out a trailer or a TV spot or this them talking would do, because it shows that these people aren't just doing it because they can, they're actually pushing the envelope with the technology, much like George Lucas did almost 40 years ago with Star Wars. They're pushing the technology, sure, not as much as George did here, mind you, but it still shows that the movie has a heart as well, because the directors are fantastic guys. I've seen the last movie they made, obviously Bad Boys for Life, and I was disappointed when Batgirl got cancelled, because they're quite talented guys. I think they nailed the look, and they nailed the visuals of both these two Bad Boys films, and I think, you know, I hope to see Batgirl one day, but I'm diverting once again. As always, as I am a film soundtrack and score kind of guy, let's talk about the music. The score in this film is once again composed by Lorne Balfe, who composed the music for the previous film. Smashed it. Score's great, I'm not going to lie to you. I'm not going to lie to you, upon watching the film, I noticed a few times where he literally just ripped out sounds and even elements used directly from the Mission Impossible Fallout score. You'll know what I mean when you watch the film if you know much about the Mission Impossible Fallout score, but you can literally hear where it's pulled directly out of Mission Impossible Fallout and put here. I've not got nothing against it, because why waste stuff that you've done like that? As long as you don't directly hear the Mission Impossible theme, which you don't, it's perfectly fine, but it does kind of... For the general audience, it ain't going to do shit, but for actual film enthusiasts, which I know is not the people they're actually going for this movie, so you can just completely fucking ignore what I'm about to say, because it's probably just bullshit that I thought of, but for someone like me who pays attention to the most minute details about sound design, soundtrack and score, it is something that kind of just pulled me out personally. I'm not going to say it's going to pull everyone out, because it definitely won't. It's a little thing that no one's really going to give a fuck about, but for me personally, it kind of... didn't feel like it was an homage cliche. It felt like it was just time was of the essence, he had this element left over, just chuck it in and call it a day kind of thing, because there's no real reason to reference Mission Impossible in a Bad Boys movie, like, if you ask me, despite the fact obviously they share him as a connection at the moment, there's no real reason to do that. So it's a little bit off-putting for someone like me, but for the general audience, they're not going to care. The movie's fun, okay, the movie's great, and I highly recommend you go check it out. Thanks so much for watching. Have a wonderful day. Don't forget to click subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.